Indeed,
yeah, it was.
All right, Mike, you'll be the leadoff hitter whenever you're ready to make your first statement.
You want me to make a statement, or are y'all going to ask questions?
Obviously,
they did a great job coming back. I mean, we did a real, you know, we knew going in how good that little guard was, you know, and I think we did a great job on him in the first half, held him down to two. You know, at the end, I mean, 27, unbelievable. He just made some really tough shots that I thought we did a good job out on him. You know, we let him shake us a couple of times, but for the most part, you know, we were on him. You know, one time we fouled him and he still made it. So, you know, and that single-handedly kind of got him back. Obviously, it didn't help us having Scott Dennis in foul trouble the whole second half, and that kind of, you know, broke our rhythm. Obviously, he's a key guy to what we do offensively and just keeping our rhythm. But these guys obviously stepped up big, made some big shots and big plays, and that's, you know, at this time of the year, that's what it's about. It's about your go-to guys making shots and plays.
You mentioned Scott, but boy, what a shot when he got back in the game late.
Yeah, he hit a big three.
Huge shot.
Hit a big three. Shot clock was winding down, yeah. And you know these two were together. We kind of had them isolated, and that, you got to have that. You know, you're gonna have to make plays like that. And we shouldn't have had to burn them today.
Yeah, true.
I mean, we should have been coasting there at the end, and you know how it happened. In some ways, I think we got a little sloppy. I think there's a tendency to let the game get a little more physical when you've got a 20-point lead, and I think it did get physical, and we weren't strong enough sometimes with the ball, and you know, made some mistakes, made some turnovers against their pressure that, you know, obviously we didn't need to do, that made it more pressure down the stretch, but we survived, you know.
Yeah. Zach, were you or Harry either way? Was it easy as it looked for 35 minutes? I mean, you got a 24-point lead with 5-plus to go. Was it as easy as it looked?
I guess I'll start first. I don't know if it was as easy as it was, but we were definitely getting, you know, our game plan. We were executing pretty well. We were getting open looks, and, you know, like we were playing inside out, which is what we kind of tried to focus on. And, you know, with Harry hitting some big threes and stuff like that, we pretty much executed our game plan until we kind of broke down at the end.
We kind of came to the game, you know, thinking that, you know, everybody's wanting to play hard because it's either win or go home now. So, I mean, none of the games are really going to be easy. So, I mean, we felt that if we came in, played defense, basically, if we really just locked down and played defense, shots were going to come. We were going to make shots, and we were going to be successful, and that's what ended up happening.
Harry, with Scott in foul trouble, I mean, I know I've looked at some numbers. You've scored some points in some games, but you're not really a scorer. But did you kind of put it upon yourself to kind of be more of a factor on the scoring end with Scott in foul trouble?
Yeah, I mean, coaching the guys gave me a lot of confidence to just go out there and play. And, I mean, I saw that one of our key guys was really struggling as far as not even just scoring struggling. He just couldn't stay in the game. He was in foul trouble the whole game.
Right.
So, I mean, it was almost if somebody didn't step up, because Zach was doing his part. He was doing what he was supposed to do, all conference player, playing like he was supposed to play. I mean, I just came in and felt that the only way I was going to give the seniors another chance to play was to step up, and that's what I did.
And the thing about Scott, too, I mean, we had Scott the whole first half, essentially. We had to pull him out right near the end. He got his second foul, and we took him out with about 3 or 4 minutes to go. But, you know, really the lead we had, you know, it was 21 at halftime. So the 24 really didn't change that much. It was pretty evenly played throughout most of the second half. And, you know, and we knew going in, I mean, we looked at their numbers coming from their conference tournament. You know, they had 109 or 110 points in one of their games. We knew that they could put a lot of points on the board, and we talked about it at halftime, like, hey, we can't let this turn into a racehorse game. But on the other hand, too, when you're being pressed, and we did handle the press, you know, where we continued to hold the lead, is earlier in the half, we were handling the press. We were making the pad. You know, Zach got some easy baskets. Harry made some good plays penetrating. You know, he had a dunk one time. And, you know, we got a lot of easy baskets. But, you know, at the end, you know, it just got a little crazy. And, you know, and again, when you're the team that's ahead and you can kind of feel it slipping away from you like that, sometimes it's hard not to panic a little bit. And, you know, and then again, the reality of the situation, you know, when you know that, hey, we had a 20-point lead, now it's a 10-point lead, you know, now it's a 7-point lead, and, you know, boy, really, the pressure really shifts, and again, like you said, that's where Scott stepped up, made a big shot, and, you know, Harry made some big free throws down the stretch. He kept us comfortable, too. I mean, I think he hit four of them you know, the first time it was a 1-1. If he misses that front end, well, we're really fighting for our lives.
Coach, I know you get kind of limited exposure to the other conference, how much tape you can see and things like that.
Yeah.
But are there drastic differences, or what are the personality differences between Gulf South and Sunshine?
Well, that's a good question. You know, I don't think there's drastic. I mean, I think they're both obviously really good leagues, and, you know, and it goes in cycles. You know, some years, you know, you get a powerhouse team from one or the other that, you know, seems to be the team to beat kind of thing. But I think year in, year out, you're always going to have teams that are very competitive. You come to this region. We've been fortunate enough to come here 3 times. And most years I come, well, it's kind of like the first game today. You know, watch that, and there's our third-place team. I think what was Eckerd, second or third, you know. And it was a hard-fought game. You know, and they're the kind of games you feel like if you played again in 2 days, it could easily go the other way, any of these games. You know, we've got a lot of respect for that league. It's tough because, on one hand, you know, the one game we got on Florida Southern was their Rollins game. And the only game we're allowed to get is their last game played. What the NCAA makes you do is you get the last game they played against a non-tournament team. So that was the first round of their conference tournament at Rollins. Well, of course, in Rollins zones for 40 minutes because that's their game, that's their style. Now, offensively, Rollins is a little bit like us. So, you know, we got a little bit of a look to kind of feel like what they would do against us defensively. But as far as really being able to get a feel for how they were going to attack offense, other than just looking at the stats and realizing that Seth Evans could beat you by himself if you let him, and he darn near did it down that stretch.
Okay,
appreciate it.
Thank you
guys.